In this tutorial, we'll take a tour of the Construct 3 game engine. Whether you're new to the platform or a seasoned developer, this video will provide an overview of how to get started building games with Construct 3. Let's begin. Let's start by covering how to access your Construct 3 account. Depending on how your instructor set up your access, you can log in one of two ways. The first way is via a timed access code. This access code would be provided to you by your instructor. Once obtained, head over to editor.construct.net and click on the account link in the upper right corner. Then select Enter Access Code. Depending on the length your teacher set up, your timed access will vary. The second option is Account Seat Access. For this option, you would have previously created an account and your instructor added your account to gain seat access. To get started with this option, simply go to editor.construct.net and log into your account. Now that you're logged in, let's dive into the start page. Here you'll find templates and example projects that you can open and explore. You can also use this page to import game files or access cloud-saved game files from your preferred cloud service. For the purpose of this tutorial, let's open a sample project. Click on the search bar and type in golf. Then click Open Project to view the game file. Now that we've opened a project in Construct 3, let's take a look around. We'll break this tour up into six sections: User Interface, Layouts and Event Sheets, Objects and Properties, Animations Editor, Previewing Games, and Exporting and Saving. Let's begin. The Construct 3 user interface is broken up into different bars. We've got the Project bar, which shows us all the layout, event sheets, objects, and files in our project. The Layers bar, which shows us the order of objects in a given layout. The Properties bar, which shows us the details of a given object, and more. You can toggle which bars are visible by going to Menu, View, Bars, and select the ones you'd like to show. You can see the current user interface is using the light theme, but if you prefer it to be dark, you can easily manage this. Go to Menu, Settings. Under the Theme section, you can select Dark or Light. Within your settings, you can also choose your default save options and more. Now that you've seen the basic view, let's dive into layouts and event sheets. In Construct 3, a layout is a screen that the player will eventually interact with. It will contain the game displays, characters, objects, and more. In this game project, we have two layouts, which you can access by double-clicking on under the Layouts folder in the project bar. Layouts have their own properties, like size, which event sheet contain its code, and more. You can view a layout's properties by selecting it. So, where's all the code stored? If you guessed the event sheets, you'd be right. The game project has one event sheet, but many games will contain multiple event sheets. To view an event sheet, double-click it in the project bar. In Construct 3, programming is done via visual scripting. Every piece of code, i.e. event, contains a condition and an action. Think of it like an if-then statement. If the event condition is met, then the action will occur. This game file has a lot of different types of events, like touch controls for the player, to physics events to control the golfing mechanics of the game. This event sheet is neatly organized with groups and comments. The groups are larger blocks that contain like events, whereas the comments are the yellow notes that provide us with some explanations for each group of code. Pretty cool, right? You'll notice that some of these events are referencing different objects. Let's dive into objects and their properties next. In Construct 3, there are many different object types. This can be anything from a sprite, like a main character of a game, to a keyboard or touch control. If you look under the Object Types folder in the project bar, you'll see a plethora of object types. These ultimately make up everything you see and don't see in our game. Let's take a look at one of these objects. Go ahead and select the ball object. When we select an object, we can view its individual properties in the Properties bar. Under the Object Type Property section, we can see that this object is a sprite type. Sprites have unique properties in that not only do they have a specific position and visibility in the game, but we can also add behaviors like physics and motion and create animations for them in our games. Ball sprite in this particular game has one behavior, the physics behavior. You can expand behavior and observe all the sub-properties that make the ball work the way it does. Now let's take a look at the animations editor. For sprites in Construct 3, we can easily animate them using the animations editor. To open the editor, you'll need to select a sprite object type. So go ahead and double-click on the confetti object in the project bar. By double-clicking any sprite, you can open its animations editor. Alternatively, you can select the sprite object and scroll down to the sprite properties in the properties bar and click edit next to the animations field. Once you've got the animations editor open, you can view the different design tools that you can use to draw and design sprites in Construct 3. You can also import designs made outside of Construct using the open folder icon. To create an animation, you'd utilize the frames bar in the animations editor. As you can see with this sprite, these three frames make up the confetti sprite's only animation. Sprites can have as many animations as you'd like them to have. Once your sprites and game is ready to go, it's time to preview it. Previewing your game is quick and simple. While in Construct 3, look to the toolbar and click the preview button. This opens a new window for you to preview and play your game without having to leave Construct 3, which is pretty awesome. If you want to share your preview with someone remotely, click on the drop-down arrow on the preview button and select Remote Preview. This provides you with a link to share and a QR code to scan for mobile testing. Easy as pie. Exporting and saving your games is equally simple. If you go to Menu, Project, Export, from there you can choose your export options, whether it's HTML5, Facebook, iOS, Android, desktop, or beyond. It's an intuitive process. Saving is just as simple. In Construct 3, you have two primary save options, Cloud Save and Download a File. With the Cloud Save option, you can save your file to your cloud service of choice, Google Drive, OneDrive, or Dropbox. Through Construct, you'll connect to your cloud account, and saving is as simple as clicking the Save button while you're working. If you prefer to manually save your files, go to Menu, Project, Save As, Download a Copy. Construct 3 files are identified by their C3P extension. However, older file formats can also be found as CapX. There you go, a whirlwind tour of the Construct 3 game engine. Building games with Construct 3 is fun and rewarding with the browser-based engine, visual scripting, and overall intuitive interface. Throughout this course, you'll learn more specifics on how to build games, but for now, take some time to tinker around with the game template file and others made available via the start page. Have fun and good luck!